Junhu never set out to become a mathematician. As a teenager, he dreamed of poetry, not polynomial. But life has a way of leading us down unexpected paths. Years after dropping out of high school to write, he found himself drawn to something he had once avoided: mathematics. It wasn't through formulas or equations that he found his way, but through curiosity, through patterns, through the same search for beauty that had once guided his writing. This is the story of a man who wandered into mathematics and, in doing so, reshaped the way we understand the hidden structures of the universe. Someone who found mathematics not in formulas, but in beauty. A man who once dreamt of writing verses, but instead found poetry in numbers. And in doing so, he reshaped the world of combinatorics, the mathematical study of patterns, arrangements, and hidden structures. Junhu was born in California in 1983, but he grew up in South Korea, where his father taught statistics and his mother was a professor of Russian literature. From a young age, he was drawn to words, ideas, and philosophy, but math? That was his weak subject. As a teenager, Hu wanted to be a poet. He dropped out of high school at 16, spending 2 years immersed in writing. He was captivated by the beauty of words and the elegance of language, convinced that he would become a literary giant. But something changed. He realized that poetry was too self-centered, too focused on the inner world. He wanted something external, universal, something that existed outside of himself. And so he enrolled at Seoul National University with the vague idea of becoming a science journalist. For years, mathematics remained an afterthought. Ha failed courses, skipped lectures, and drifted through academia without direction. But in his sixth year of college, he wandered into a class taught by Heisuke Hironaka, a legendary mathematician and Fields medalist. Hironaka was charismatic, unpredictable, and deeply passionate about mathematics. His lectures were less about formulas and more about ideas. Unsolved problems, deep mysteries, and elegant structures hidden in numbers. Hu, intrigued by this approach, began asking questions after class. Soon these questions turned into conversations, and then into something more. Hironaka took him under his wing, recognizing an unusual spark in the young man. He invited Ha to study with him, even taking him to Japan. For the first time, Ha wasn't just learning maths, he was exploring it, treating it like poetry, a canvas for discovery. For most people, mathematics is about rigid formulas and precise calculations. But Junhu saw something different. He saw shapes where others saw numbers, patterns where others saw randomness. For centuries, mathematicians had struggled to understand combinatorics, the mathematics of counting and arranging objects. A deck of cards can be shuffled in over 8 multiplied by 10 to the power of 67 ways. That's astronomical. Arranging books on a shelf or optimizing a computer network might seem simple at first, but as the numbers grow, these problems explode in complexity. Traditional methods, based on equations and brute force calculations, failed to keep up. Hu, however, approached combinatorics from a completely new perspective. Instead of treating arrangements as isolated cases, he realized that they could be understood through geometry. By mapping combinatorial problems onto geometric spaces, he was able to extract hidden structures that had eluded mathematicians for decades. At first, this idea seemed strange, even counterintuitive. Combinatorics deals with discrete objects, like individual elements in a set, while geometry is all about continuous spaces. How could the two possibly be connected? But Hu saw the link? He noticed that combinatorial patterns behaved like topological surfaces, smooth, flowing, and connected in unexpected ways. And by translating these problems into geometric terms, he found a powerful new approach to solving them. One of combinatorics' biggest unsolved problems was the Rhoda conjecture, proposed in 1970. It suggested that certain mathematical objects, called matroids, had hidden geometric properties that influence their structure in profound ways. Matroids are abstract mathematical structures that capture the essence of independence in a wide range of settings, from vector spaces to graph theory. The Rhoda conjecture predicted that the coefficients of a special polynomial associated with these matroids would always follow a pattern known as log concavity, meaning that they steadily increase to a peak and then decrease, like the smooth curve of a mountain range. This property wasn't just an aesthetic curiosity. It hinted at deep underlying mathematical symmetry, suggesting that matroids were governed by principles far beyond mere combinatorial rules. For decades, mathematicians tried to prove this, but the tools of discrete mathematics alone weren't enough. The breakthrough came when Jun He and his collaborators introduced techniques from algebraic geometry, a branch of mathematics that studies shapes through equations. By treating matroids as if they had continuous geometric properties, they unlocked a new perspective, proving the conjecture and revealing a bridge between combinatorics and geometry that no one had expected. He, with collaborators Karim Adeprasito and Eric Katz, approached the problem differently. They built a cohomology ring directly from matroids, something never done before. This allowed them to use a powerful tool from algebraic geometry, Hodge theory. The Fields Medal Committee recognised his groundbreaking work on multiple long-standing problems, including the proof of the Dowling-Wilson conjecture for geometric lattices, the development of the theory of Lorentzian polynomials, and the proof of the Strong-Mason conjecture. Each of these achievements has deepened the connection between combinatorics and geometry, revealing hidden mathematical structures that shape our understanding of both fields. Their breakthrough proof was unexpectedly elegant, bridging two fields of mathematics that had long seemed to have little in common. And with it, Ha solved the Rhoda conjecture, unravelling a mystery that had baffled mathematicians for decades. Jun He's work isn't just a mathematical curiosity, it has profound implications in the real world. His discoveries in combinatorics have introduced new perspectives on how we think about optimization, computation, and data organization. Take artificial intelligence and data science, for example. Machine learning algorithms rely on massive data sets, and organizing this information efficiently is a crucial challenge. His mathematical tools help refine data structures and search algorithms, making it easier for AI to process and retrieve relevant information. In the field of cryptography and network security, encoding information securely is paramount. The same combinatorial structures Ha studied in relation to matroids play a role in encryption methods, ensuring that digital communication remains safe from cyber threats. And then there's an indirect influence on quantum computing, where the complexity of combinatorial structures intersects with the physics of quantum mechanics. Ha's insights into how discrete objects behave within geometric frameworks could help model quantum states, offering new ways to tackle problems in physics and computation that classical methods struggle with. But perhaps the most remarkable aspect of He's work isn't just its direct applications. It's the fundamental shift in perspective it offers. He revealed that what once seemed like disconnected fields, combinatorics and geometry, are in fact deeply intertwined. His discoveries open new doors for future research, where mathematicians and scientists alike can explore hidden patterns that were once beyond reach. Despite his achievements, He remains deeply humble. In one of his interviews, he remarked how he still does not feel like a real mathematician. Even after winning the Fields Medal, he admitted saying how he was worried that they would eventually figure out that he is not that good. Unlike many mathematicians, he isn't fast or competitive. He works slowly, methodically, and intuitively. He believes in taking long walks, letting ideas simmer, and approaching problems with patience rather than urgency. Mathematics, to him, is like poetry. A search for beauty, a way of seeing the world not in numbers, but in patterns, connections, and elegant truths. Junher's story proves that there's no single path to greatness. He wasn't a child prodigy. He didn't train in elite math competitions. He found mathematics by accident, through curiosity, persistence, and an artist's eye for beauty. So the next time you shuffle a deck of cards or arrange books on a shelf, remember, there might be a hidden mathematical truth waiting to be uncovered. Because as Junhui has shown, mathematics isn't just logic, it's poetry.